Hello, Rajendra. Can you make Tapan Pade as host of this meeting, co-host of the meeting, so that he can present his screen?
Dinesh garu nene
Tapan Pade andu chodandi.
Just. तपन कुमार ना
हाँ तपन कुमार
उनको अनदर पर्सन है और
ओके निम्शो
यश यश
यश
మిగతా వాళ్ళని అలౌ చేస్తున్నాను అడ్మిట్ చేస్తున్నాను అందరు వచ్చారు కదా మన వాళ్ళు
ఆ రిసోర్సెస్ అందరు వచ్చారు మిగతా అడ్మిట్ చేసేయండి
या यश और तपन
गुड आफ्टरनून सर टुडे तपन विल बी टेकिंग सर
या ओके
तो शैल वी स्टार्ट द सेशन सर
Yeah, Yash, you can start the session.
Okay, sir. Tapan?
Yes, yes.
Okay, I can proceed.
Yeah. So, thank you, Yash.
Okay.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. So, like from last 2 days, I think you all people have learned about, you know, the aircraft design, and the next 3 days, like, we are going to discuss about the aircraft manufacturing process. So in the aircraft manufacturing, basically we are going to, we are going to discuss regarding the turbofan, you know, engine manufacturing process. So before starting the session, I want to show you the, you know, schedule, like what we have prepared for you all people. So let me present my screen. So,
yes, it's visible. Yeah.
Okay. So, this is the thing, like what we have prepared for you people for the next 3 days. So, let me use the delivery content to you all of you. Please see. Okay, so there are 3 days program is there for the aircraft turbofan manufacturing. So for first, like today, like we are going to discuss about introduction to Delimia, so Delimia basics, and after that, like, I will be telling you about the introduction to the there are different manufacturing processes are there involved, like we will be telling you about those other things. Then directly we'll start about the, you know, MID. There are there are 4 to 5, so we'll start the first process today, you know, after that introduction. Then there are different things are there, like define the manufacturing item structure, assign the parts to the manufacturing item structure, and review the assignment status, and manage large number of member objects turbofan using groups. So these all the things are there. And day two, like, we will be discussing about the process planning and time motion study. And in the, like, if possible, we'll do the equipment allocation also. So these are all the things, like, we will be, you all people will get to know, you know, slowly, and so there is no issues. Okay. And then the day three, like, we will do the rest of the things, like assembly evaluation and the simulation of the plant. So so before that, like let me show you the day one.
Tapan, at above there is an option, just disable the notations. Annotations is there, just disable.
Okay, can you tell me where it is?
At the above, okay. Options.
Just 1 minute, sorry, just 1 minute. Let me stop sharing.
While sharing only, you can adjust that.
Where? Clear, this is the one.
Annotations will be there.
Annotation, just 1 minute. Can you tell, can you help me out? I am unable to find out this.
That option, we won't be seeing that, but only you will be seeing that.
I don't know, like, where it is.
In the more options, there will be annotations will be there. That one you just disable. And after that, stop sharing and reshare it.
Okay, more option. Okay, just 1 minute.
Annotations will be there.
Let me stop sharing. Okay. So, more. The thing is, I'm not getting the option. Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you share it again?
Okay. Yeah. Is there any problem is coming? Still, yeah, still it is coming. Yeah, disable annotation for others. Yeah, I have disabled that one.
Okay. Now reshare it.
Okay, no problem. Just one. Is everything fine now?
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah. So just now I showed you about the, you know, like the delivery content, like what are the things we are going to discuss. Okay. So again, I'll show you because there was some, you know, some pictures came at the time. So let us forget about day one, day two, day three, these all the things. So today we will be covering about the this introduction to Dalmia, okay, Dalmia basics. Then this introduction to digital turbo fan manufacturing process and MID. So it is MID is one of the process of this Dalmia, okay. So this digital turbo manufacturing is first process is MID. So we will be covering these all things. Okay. So rest 2 days we will be discussing later. Okay. So first what I will do is that I'll go to the day one. Okay. Then I'll tell you about the Dalmia basics. I think many of you, you know, have cleared the basics, I'm sure, but still you have to know like the, you know, we'll repeat once again, you know, the basics of the Dalmia. Okay. Okay, so all of you, I think, aware of this one, like this is the 3D compass. I think in your college, like when the trainer in the initial class itself, like the trainee used to introduce about this one. So this is a 3D compass. Okay, there are in the four direction, there are four different applications are available. Okay, so like here, like as you know, 3D modeling applications, social and application, information intelligence, these all the rest of the applications are there. So this Dalmia is coming under simulation applications. You all people are aware of this one. Okay. So I'll go to the next slide. Okay. So I'll go to the next slide. Okay. So this is the protocol of Dalmia. Okay. So the for Dalmia, there are three things are involved. Okay. So one is engineer, then second one is operate, and the third one is optimize. So what is the engineer means? Whatever the, you know, this process planning, like you all people, I think, heard about this process planning, right? Process planning, manufacturing item definition, the assembly evaluation, equipment allocation, these all the applications are coming under this engineer. Okay, so here, like what happened, like you're starting like from the scratch to like for the advanced manufacturing process, these all the things are covered in this engineering. Okay, engineer. Then operate means what? This is all about the manufacturing and plant. This is all related to that one. Okay, and then third one is optimize. Optimize is all about the Dalmia appraisal. Okay, so that is the advanced level of Dalmia, advanced level of the digital manufacturing process. So we will be discussing about the first process only, that is engineer. Okay, so I'll the next thing I'm going to tell you about the engineering process. Okay, so in the engineering, five methods are there. One is collaborative manufacturing, second one is process planning, and the third one is ergonomy, fourth one is robotics and fabrication. Okay, so let me tell you about the collaborative manufacturing. In the collaborative manufacturing, what will happen is that there are multiple groups you need to combine, and they need to, you know, work together in order to perform the actions and execute the operations. Okay, so this is all about the collaborative manufacturing. Okay, so here what required is the multiple things are required. Okay, in order to perform the actions to set the plans and execute the operations. Okay, Then we'll go to the next one, that is process planning. Okay. In the process planning, what will happen is that, like, the sequence of operations or process, like, you have to follow in order to produce a product or part. Okay. So here, what happened, like, there are sequence of operations need to be executed in order to get a product. Okay. In the process planning, there are many things are there. Okay. We will be discuss these all the things later. Okay. Then the third one is ergonomy. Okay, in the ergonomy, what will happen is that, like, in order to get a you know, product or something, like, you have to you know, assign some you know, human activities need to be involved, right? So in so these ergonomics, here the physically physical forcing worker should be required, you know, in order to, you know, combine this resource and you know, operation is all the things. Okay, in order to combine these all things, ergonomics is required. Okay, so this is all about the ergonomy. Okay, then fourth one is robotics. So robotics, like, for us, like, for the manufacturing of the turbo fan, like, the robotics is required. Okay, but here we are not going to do, because we will be not doing the factory floor simulation. So for this, robotics is not much required. We will just follow the basic manufacturing process only. Okay. So in the robotics, but you people should know, like, what is this robotics in the in the Dalmia. In the robotics, what will happen, like, it integrates the, you know, computer science and engineering, okay, to develop the product, okay, and at the same time to manufacture it, you know, for design and manufacturing, like, we are involving the computer science and engineering. So this robotics is helpful for the complete you know, development of the product. Okay, then the fabrication, the final step is fabrication. Okay, when these all the things are done digitally, okay, then we'll go for the fabrication of the product. Okay, so in the fabrication, like, you know, you need to, you know, you need to produce your product, you know, whether it is an innovation product or whatever it is. Okay, by following the, by, you know, by using the manufacturing processes. Okay, so you need to get the final output over here in the fabrication. So these four steps are involved in the Dalmia. Okay, so these four, the first is collaborative manufacturing, process planning, ergonomy, and robotics. These four steps are required. Okay, then only finally we'll go for the fabrication. Okay, so if any doubt is there, please let me know, or else, like, so that if any doubt is there, please let me know. Or shall I go ahead? You can write in, you can type in the chat box also, no problem. Okay, explain ergonomy. Okay, no problem. So ergonomy means what? Like, see, for example, you want to manufacture product. Okay, so in order to get that product, you need to, you know, there are different processes are there. You need to follow those processes. First is what? You need a digital product. Okay. Then second one is what? You need a resource. Resources is required. Okay. Then process is also required. There are three things are required. One is a digital product. Okay. Where the mathematical calculation, everything will be there. Okay. But you are looking for a physical product. Okay. So what you have to do in order to get the physical product, you have to combine these all the three. Okay. Product, process, and resource. So in order to run these all the things, you need the ergonomy. So without physical hard work, you are unable to do these all the things, right? So this ergonomics is that one. So basic definition of ergonomics is that one. Okay. So what you will do by using the ergonomics, you will assign these ergonomics to different tasks. Like, you go here, okay, for, you know, for holding something, or for keeping the objects from here to there, or for transferring the transferring the models from here to there. Okay, so both for these work, all the works, like, ergonomics is required. Okay, so these ergonomics are very important, you know, while creating any kind of plant layout or any kind of, you know, manufacturing process, these ergonomics is important. Okay, so I hope this time you all people are clear. So what is collaborative manufacturing? Somebody asked. Okay, so collaborative manufacturing means what means, like, you have to, like, there are different works out there, okay? Like, as I said, process planning, ergonomics, robot fitness, and fabrication, all the things are there. So here, what will happen, these all the information, these all the applications will be available here, okay? By using this collaborative manufacturing application, what can be done is that you will be, you know, combine these all the four things, okay? And after that, you can perform the actions on this and you can execute the operations in order to get the product. That's it, nothing else. So I hope many people are clear in this, clear the engineering process, okay? Then we will be elaborating about the collaborative manufacturing. Okay, what is this collaborative manufacturing? There is nothing, just basic definitions are only there, okay? So why collaborative manufacturing is required for the for manufacturing, okay? To there are customer challenges are there, like the software and workflow migration and reduce duplication of data and reduce duplication of effort, okay? So what are the benefits like you are going to get from this collaborative manufacturing is that, like, the single data repository with the design, single data repository for all the manufacturing domains, and common configuration management. So these all the things, maybe some people may able to understand or some people may not be able to understand. So basically we will be not discussing these all the things here, okay? So practically we will be, you know, cover many things practically only, okay? So definition, may some people understand, some may not understand, so we'll skip that one. So we'll go for the process planning, okay? So process planning, like as I told you, like, what is the process planning is, it is a sequence of operations, like you have to involve, okay, operations or processes, like, you know, in order to get a product, in order to produce a product or part or assembly, whatever it is, okay? So you have to follow a sequence of operations, okay? So in this, for you people, like, we are going to tell you about the turbofan assembly, for example. So here, what are the process planning, like we are going to follow, like MID, process planning, okay, then time motion study. So these, there are different applications are there. Then you will combine these all the things, so you will get the final output, okay? So so there is no issues, okay? So why process planning is required? To reduce the so the benefits are, like, to reduce the planning, manpower and time, work order sequence for ease of installation, unbuildable conditions eliminated, and rework minimal. So there is no problem, like, this is just a Delmia basics, nothing. So many people are good in the Delmia basics, so there is no basics. Just for understanding purposes I'm just doing it, so there is no need to, you know, get much headache on this, okay? Just you should know, just these are the basics. Then ergonomics is also there. So why fabrication is required? So we'll skip these all. Just you understand the basic, you know, definition only. Okay. So nothing much required to understand. Okay. So directly, like, we'll be discussing, you know, more on practical. Okay. Not the, you know, less on the definition. Okay. And PPT. So just one. Sorry, I opened a wrong slide. Just one. Wrong PPT. Just one. So, as I told you, our target is to, you know, to get the digital turbofan manufacturing, okay, by using Delmia. Okay. Okay. So this is the, like, from here onwards, please be attentive, okay? And whatever the things is required, you please ask there itself, okay? Whatever the doubts and whatever the questions are coming to your mind, please ask there itself, okay? So you can interrupt me anytime, no problem. So first thing is that, like, we are, like, from last 2 days, like, you have told you about the, you know, aircraft styling and the design of the aircraft, right? Then the next one is the turbofan manufacturing, right? The next 3 days, okay? So first you people should know, like, what is the turbofan, okay? So turbofan is nothing but it is an aircraft engine, okay? So there are different kind of aircraft engines are there. So this is one of the turbo aircraft engine, okay, which is very advanced one. Okay, so the basic definition is also mentioned over here. Okay, so it is nothing but a type of air breathing jet engine, okay, that is widely used in the aircraft propulsion. Okay, so this what is like turbofan is like turbine and fan. Turbofan, there are two parts are there. Okay, one is turbine and second one is fan. So turbo is nothing but a gas turbine engine which achieves mechanical energy from combustion, and the fan, a ducted fan that uses the mechanical energy from the gas turbine to accelerate the air rearwards. Okay, so this is all about the basic definition of the turbofan. Okay, then there are major sections of turbofan also here I have written. One, air inlet, compression section, combustion section, turbine section, exhaust section, and accessory section. Okay, and here the process is involved, like how it is going to perform the engine, how it works, these all the things are there. So this is all about the theoretical. Okay, so you can just for your understanding, I kept these two slides. Okay, what is the turbine and what are the things are there. Okay, then we'll go to the next one. Okay, so just 1 minute. So as I told you we will be focusing more on the manufacturing of the turbofan. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that before starting of that one, you should know like what is the manufacturing engineer role. Okay, what is the role of a manufacturing engineer? You all people should know. Can somebody tell me what is the like manufacturing role? What is a manufacturing engineer do? Can anybody tell me? Can somebody tell me? Okay, so no problem. Okay, creates and manage the process, the product. Okay, so in the manufacturing engineering means what? It is a role like where like it will provide you the easy to use a tool to get the solution. Okay, for the process engineers. Okay, for creating the and managing the product. Okay, and as I told you, like in order to get the physical product, you have to involve three things. One is product, process, and resource. Okay, these all the things it will combine. The engineer's role is like the engineer should combine these all the three things. Okay. And at the same time, processing has take all over. So you have to combine these all the three things, and you need to get the output product. Okay, the role of manufacturing role in engineering is that one only. Okay, not anything, nothing else. Okay. So one of the companies there, Turbo Air Wings Aerospace Limited, which manufactures the aircraft engines. Okay. So at the same time, turbofans and turbojet engines, they are manufacturing from the couple of decades. Okay, so here is the one company is there. Okay, now yeah, slowly we will move to the manufacturing process and all the things. Okay, so what are the things can be done? Okay, like for the what are the modifications can be done? And so as you can see, so you use the existing turbofan engine, okay, augment the manufacturing item structure can be done. Okay, you can modify the existing manufacturing process plan and update the resource structure for the new requirements. Okay, so these are the four things done in that company. So the next one is, what is a process plan? So process plan is like, it is a step like before manufacturing. Okay. Sequence of operations or processes need to be produced in part or assembly. Like there also, like we have discussed in the previous PPT, there it was process plan, it was also there. Okay. So it is nothing but like, before manufacturing a product or part, you have to follow some sequence of operations. Okay, so that is called as process plan. Okay, then we'll go to the next one. Is there any doubt, is there, guys? Please let me know. Am I audible properly, right? There is no problem for you people, I guess. So we'll go to the next slide. Okay. So here, like it has written introduction to the process planning in the digital factory. Okay. So what is the process planning? What is a process? So process is nothing but to achieve a goal. Okay. To achieve any particular part or product. You are looking for any part or product. So what you will do? Follow this process method. Okay, so what are the inputs are required for a process, right? So output is like, we have to get a product, we have to get a physical product. But what are the inputs are required? Like, see, PPR, here it is, these are the inputs. Okay, one is a product, one is a digital product is required, and second one is process is required. Okay, what are the processes are there? Like, we will be discussing these all the things later, but you should know what are the things required. One is a digital product, second one is process, and then third one is resource. Resource means what? Like whether it is a conveyor belt, there are different things are there, okay, in the resource. So you should know, you just know the things, product, process, and resource. So this is to achieve a single product, okay. But what is the purpose of a digital factory? To get to do the, it helps to, get a complex production process. So digital product. So when you are looking for a number of product, when you are planning to achieve number of products, then what you have to do? You have to go for the digital product. Okay, in the here what Philippine, all the things are simple. I mean there are complex things are there, like which makes it easier. Digital factory will make the things easier. Okay, then it facilitates planning by producing a consistent digital data model. Okay, and at the same time, this digital factory is used for the production purposes. Okay, so this is all about the, like, here what it will do, we will convert the process into a digital factory. Okay, so here these are the inputs are there. Okay, by help of these inputs, we will convert a single product to number of products. Okay, we'll convert those all the things. So the number of products, how we'll achieve? By using
can you do it in the slideshow? Like the words are not that much visible.
Slideshow?
Yeah.
Okay. Sometimes, okay. Yeah, so is it visible properly?
Yeah, now it's proper, next. Yeah.
But at the same time, the next slide is not coming. No, when I'm pressing.
The arrow keys are not working.
That is the problem I'm getting here. Yeah, directives are not working. Yeah.
Okay.
So that is the issue. I'm unable to do the slideshow.
Okay, no problem. You can proceed.
Yeah. Just one more. Just one minute. Okay, now sure. Maybe just one. Okay, so I hope people are cleared on, I guess. Any officer, please ask me. So what is the process and what is the digital factory? What is the purpose of process and what are the inputs required in order to run the process? Okay, and how can you achieve the digital factory? And what are the points are helpful for the digital factory? What is the purpose of digital factory? All the things we have discussed over here. Okay, so for process, inputs are product, digital product, process, and okay. So you know these 3 points. These 3 points are enough. Okay, so these definitely we will be elaborating these all the things later. Okay, you should know the points. That's it. Nothing else required. Okay, so this is you can see product, process, and resource. And just now in the previous slide only, I just we had discussed about product, process, and resource. Okay, so for product, like when we combine these all the things, this is called okay. So this is PPR model for the process planning. Okay. So under process planning, there are 3 things are required. So product means what? As I told you, a digital product. Digital product means what? E-commerce. Okay. Like there are some engineering. Mathematical calculation, everything will be there in the and the 3D model of the product. Okay. This will be there. What we will do is we'll convert that one into okay. So digital product will be that will do manufacturing bill of material. Okay, then the next method will do the process plan. Okay, and at the same time, in order to execute one operation, like we are giving some time, right? For this all things, okay, after this operation, the next operation will come. Okay, this is all the in the process. Okay, so one is product, the second one is process.
My voice is breaking. It's not understandable.
Maybe
can you check it?
Because of is it clear now?
No, still it's breaking.
Just one minute.
Okay.
Am I there now?
Can you hear me?
Hello. Hello, everyone. Is my voice clear now?
Yeah, it's clear.
It's clear. Okay. Sorry for the, you know, disturb, like, sorry for the inconvenience, like what we faced. So, let me set my screen. So, is my screen visible?
Yeah, it's visible.
Yeah. Yes, yes. So, like we had discussed about this product, process, and resource. Okay. So, product is nothing but we build a engineering bill of material and 3D model of the product. We will be converting that this E-bomb to M-bomb. Okay. After that, what we will do, we'll move to the next process, that is process plan. Okay. So here, what we will do, will be we will be creating different kind of here we will create a different kind of workstations, and we will perform different kind of we'll execute different operations over here, and at the same time we will be giving we will provide the sequence of the operations and the time second and everything the activities we will be providing in the next stage. Okay, then after that we'll move to the resources. Like as I told you, like conveyor belt, okay, is required. Conveyor belt and toolkit and storage, these all the things are required. Like these all the things are coming under resource. I hope you all people are cleared, the basic of Delmega is cleared in your colleges, I think so, during that training. So there will be no problem for you people to for understanding this, concept, I feel. Okay. So these are the things. Still, if you are not getting something, please let me know. So we will be moving to the next. So one tool is there, like I told you, like here only. The description of activities and interpend is these one things is one thing is there, right? So here, that is only that tool is process, is coming under Gantt chart. Okay. So here in the Gantt chart, what are the things can be done means like time and duration of the processes, and it will be related. It will show you the it will display you the relation between different processes. So this tool is the Gantt chart, and for this. Like you all people, please see. Okay, this is the like PPR model has done for the turbofan assembly. Okay, so here is the product bottom part and rotor will be there. So you please understand. So if I'll explain you, because I haven't started these all things, explain you. I'm not going to explain this one. Just you please understand this one. Okay, product, process, and resource, what are the things can be done? Okay. I'm not going to explain about this one because you may feel you guys may confuse it. Okay. So I hope okay. So this is the PPR model. Okay, the final step is there. Okay. So digital process of turbo engine. You people can write the processes, okay, if you want. So these are the five processes like we are going to discuss from now onwards. Okay. One is MID, planning. The second one, the third one is time motion study and equipment allocation. Fourth one and fifth one is assembly values. Okay. So by using these five processes, what we will do is we will get the final product, final output of the this turbo engine. Okay, digitally. Okay. So this is all about the the basic. Information about the manufacturing process of turbofan assembly. Okay, so still if you are getting any issue, please let me know. Maybe this is happening because of issue. Just one. Is my voice audible?
It's audible.
Is audible. Thank you. So because till now, like whatever the things we had discussed, you know, this is all about the basic information of the Dalmia and the manufacturing process, like what are the, how can we manufacture the turbofan? Okay, the manufacturing process. But we are going, now we are going to start it practically. Okay, we will be doing these all stages are there, right? Five stages are there. So we will be starting these stages now. So first one is manufacturing item definition. So please be attentive. Okay, so we will be doing practically. So I'm sure manufacturing item definition of turbofan. Still it's not clear.
It's audible only. Not open it, but
audible only. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Hello.
Yeah. No problem. We can proceed.
No problem. Yeah. So first one is, like as I told you, manufacturing item definition. Okay. So this is the first process. It's manufactured. Okay. So unfortunately, by mistake, I wrote manufactured item definition. Okay. This is the first process of the manufacturing process. Okay. So we'll open the. So directly I'll open the 3DX platform. So just one. So if any doubt is there, please ask me, or you can write in the chat box. Maybe today there is a problem is there for internet. Okay. But still. So within 1 minute we'll start. So yes, can I reconnect? Hello. 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 Yes. Yes. Are you there?
Yeah, Tapan. Yeah.
Actually, I'm getting some internet issues. So can I reconnect?
Okay.
So within 1 minute, I'll join again.
Okay.
I'm reconnecting. Okay. Just one.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, am I audible now?
Yeah, now it's clear.
Now it's clear, right? Yeah. Okay. Okay, so let me share my screen. So my screen is visible, right? To all of you. Hello.
Yeah, it's visible.
Yes, visible. Okay. So before whatever the things we had discussed till now, it is all about I'm telling you repeatedly, those all the things are basic mode. Okay. So there is no problem. I will provide the PPT. These all the things. Okay. You just go through it. You will be able to understand each and everything. Okay. So there is no issues. No need to panic. Okay, so if you are not getting some points, there is no issues. From now onwards, we are going to start it practically. Okay, please be attentive. And if you are not getting anything, please ask me, you please interrupt me. Okay. So what I'll do is that, first thing what I'll do, I'll open the turbofan. Okay, so turbofan, file is there, 3DXML file is there. Okay, I have already downloaded it. So here is the 3DXML file of that turbofan engine assembly. Then what I'll do is that now I'll open the 3DXML platform. Okay. First thing what I'll do, let me import that file. Okay. You all of you know that how to import that any kind of file. Okay. But anyway, I'm telling you, just click on the plus symbol, go to import. Okay. And after that, as you can see, already previously I imported, so the name is already appeared over here. So what I'll do, I'll just click OK. So it takes just 5 to 10 minutes for importing the file. So just wait for 1 minute more. So it will be already 85% imported. So So after import, yeah. So as you can see, this the file has imported successfully. Now what I'll do, I'll open that one. And after that, we'll get the TurboPen SMD. Okay, so as you can see, successfully we have opened the file. Okay, here is the TurboPen SMD. Okay, now what I will do is that this is just a physical product. Okay, this is a model. Okay, digital model. Now what I will do is that, as I told you, the first process is what? There are five processes like it has written over there. So first process is manufacture item definition. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll type manufacture item definition. Okay, so as you can see, here is the application. So what I'll do, I'll click on that particular application. Okay, so now as you can see, you please try, if you want to write the process, you can write. Okay, so as you can see, here, that TurboPen is there, and after that, this is the PPR context, and here the manufacturing assembly. When I enter to manufacture item definition application, there are three things appear. Okay, so here is the digital product. Okay, so what first thing what you could do? So this is called as EBOM, engineering bill of material. Okay, so what we have to do is that we have to convert this EBOM into MBOM. Okay, so how can you convert? So just see. So for that, what you have to do in order to convert EBOM to MBOM, you have to right click on the manufacturing assembly. Okay, go to the create scope tool is there. I think know about this one. Okay, so what you have to do is that you have to click on the create scope. Okay, and after that, you have to select on the TurboPen like the assembly. Okay, so as you can see, after that, the product is appeared on the tile. Okay, so this is like what we have done is that we have converted EBOM into MBOM. Okay, after that, some people I think might have know, you all people are, what you are doing is that you are going to the create slash update. Those people who knows, tell me, I'm telling about to them. So don't click on this create slash update item structure. So this is a shortcut method. Okay, no need to create anything over there. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to create your own plan. You have to create your own plan for the MBOM. So what I have to do? So here you can see the physical product is appearing on the tile. So first thing what you have to do? So here is the MBOM. Right click. Okay. So before starting this whole thing, so you just expand the physical product. Okay. How many assemblies are there? So how many assemblies are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total 11 assemblies are there, I guess. Okay. So for 11 assemblies, what you have to do, you have to create 11 manufacturing assembly. Okay. Here manufacturing assembly tool is there. Okay. So 11 time you have to click over here. Okay. You have to create. Okay. So what I have to do, because 11 assemblies are there, right? So what I'll do is I'll right click over here. Okay. I'll go to the insert procedure, okay, and I'll click on the manufacturing assembly. So 11 times you have to click, because in assembly there are so many parts are there. In one assembly there are so many parts. You need to think about the parts. Okay, you just saw that. So what you have to do, 11 times you have to click on. So as per for this model, I am preparing the MID. Okay. What I do? Okay. So one I have prepared like this, and I have to pick. Either directly from here, or as you can, the assembly tool is there, right? Just click that and click this here. Just one internet. So how many understood of this? Can someone tell me? Or any doubt is there? Just one minute. I'm getting. So here, as you can see, is a assembly size. So here, okay. So please do not ask about the basic, you know, the definitions. Whatever the definition is, then after this, you know, class, you please ask me. I'll clarify these all things. Okay. Please write if any basic definition is you want to know. Please write questions. Okay. After the class, please ask me. Please attentive in the practical session. Okay. So as you can see, 2 times I have created, but still 9 times I have to create the manufacturing assembly. Okay, so just one more time. So right click over here again. So go to the insert procedure. Again, go to assembly. Okay. You have to create your own plan according to the structure of the model. Okay, here I saw 11 assemblies there. So what I'll do, I'll create 11 manufacturing assembly. Just 1 minute. Still, internet is slow. What I'll do, again I'll go. So 4 times I've created, still 7 times I've created. Very, very basic and easy method. I tell you, easy method. No need to worry about these all the things. So 6 times I have created, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Still five times more. Okay. The plan, you know, the proper planning should be there in order to, you know, when you are planning to manufacture product, the planning, you do your own plan. Okay. And that to be in an easy way. Okay. So that, you know, there will be no difficulty while producing the product. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 3 times more. How many of you are getting these all things? Can or if somebody is not getting, please let me know so that I can clear the doubts now itself. So here what happened, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times we've created. So 10 times, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1 time more, okay. go to the insert procedure, and again you click on the manufacturing assembly. Okay. So here what I show is that for this turbofan manufacturing, I got to know that there are 11 assemblies are there. Okay. So for that, what I will do is that I'll create 11 manufacturing assembly. Okay. And under that, what I'll do, I'll get the parts of the particular. So just see 11 manufacturing assemblies there. So I 11 assemblies are there. So I've created 11 manufacturing assembly. So after that, what I'll do, I'll go to the starting one, starting manufacturing assembly. Okay. Starting assembly. In the starting assembly, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3. So three parts are there in the first assembly. So what I do, I think what I'll do is that I'll go to the particular part, I'll drag that part, and I'll bring it over here one time. Okay. Please see. Okay. So that total there. So you can see in that assembly, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3. Three parts are there. So what I'll do for that for that one, what I'll do, I have to get the parts right from this assembly. So in order to get that one, what I will do is that I'll go to the insert procedure again. I'll go to the provided part this time. Okay. So three parts are there. What I'll do? How many times I have to click? Three times. So by defaultly, this one will appear over here. So there is no problem. You just leave about this one. We'll remove that one later. So what I'll do, I'll go to the insert procedure again. So three parts are there, right? So three times I'll go to the provided part. I'll click on this particular manufacturing assembly, and three times I'll click. Okay. So one time, two times, what I'll do, I'll go to the third time. I click on third time. Video is lagging. Okay. Now, these all the things are happening because of internet only. But still, you please try to understand the method. Okay. So here, what I'll do, I'll right click again. I'll go to the insert procedure. There is that insert. Yeah, here insert procedure. Again, I'll click on the provided part. Okay. So three parts are there. So here is the assembly. Under the assembly, three parts are there. So here is, you can see here we brought the assembly. So under the three parts, we have to assign. Okay. You forget about this one. We will remove this one easily. There is no need to think about this one. So after that, what I'll do, I'll select one part, I'll drag and place it over here. Okay, the first part is done. I'll go to the second part, I'll drag and place it over here. The second one is also done. Now what I'll do, I'll go to the third one, I'll drag it and place it over the third time. Clear? Now, many people might have thinking why this one is there. Okay, so there is no problem. If you want to remove that one, there is no problem. This is might be a headache for some people. Okay, it's headache for me also, because why it is, I'm also thinking the same. So what I'll do is that I'll right click on that one. I'll go to the tree. I'll right click on that one. I'll remove the item product scope. Okay, and delete. Right click and delete. Similarly, we have done for one assembly. So you just maximize that one. You just now you expand the second one. Okay, for the second one, so this is the second assembly. What I have to do, first thing, I'll drag it and I place it on the second tile. So now this work is done. So what I'll do, I'll hide this one. Okay, I'll hide the provided part. So this is the assembly. If I expand that one, so these are the three parts are there under the first, under one assembly. Okay. Now the second one. So what I do, I already dragged it and I place it over here. The next thing what I have to do, can somebody tell me next thing what I have to do? everything is lagging. Can somebody tell me what I have to do now? So here what I'll do, there are two parts are there, right? So what I'll do, I'll right click over here. I'll go to the insert procedure. I'll two times I'll create the provided part. Again, right click, insert procedure. And again, I provide part because two parts are there, right? So here's the assembly. So again, for this one, I'll remove that one, no problem. Right click, remove item, let us go and delete. So that will be deleted. For me also, like I'm getting some internet problem today. So I hope from tomorrow onwards it will be rectified. Okay. So this is. Before that, let me second part. I'll drag. And I place it over here one part. And I'll drag another part and press it over here, second part. Okay. So this is done. Now, this you remove this one. No work of this one. Okay, it's done. So the second also done. Now hide these provided parts. Now we'll go move to the third one. So third one, you people please help me out. How will do the third one? Yeah, that's good. So we'll go to the third one. So third one, first thing what I have to do, I'll bring the assembly first. I'll drag the assembly and I'll place it on the tile. So the main assembly came over here. Now what I'll do, so let me check how many parts are there in the third. One, two, three parts are there. So again, what I'll do, right click here, insert procedure. So three times we have to click on the provided part because three parts are there. So create your own plan, okay, every time. Never click on the create slash update item structure, okay. You please forget this method. You have to follow this method from now onwards. Insert procedure, okay. Then again, you have to click on the provided part because three parts are there, right? So again, for the third one, again, I'll get provided part, okay. Now drag all the three parts and place it over here. First part is done. Second part is also done. Now third also done. Okay. Now what you have to do? You have to remove the first two is done, right? So I'll expand the third one. Right click, remove item product scope and delete. Okay, so the third one is also done. Similarly, you have to do for the we have to go for the next one also. So 11 times you have to do like this. Okay, for the one assembly you have to do like this. So 1, 2, 3 is done. Now we'll go for the four. So bring the fourth part item over here. Okay. Expand. That this is a provided part. Two parts are there, right? So this is the correct method. Like now bring this one. Drag it over here, drag and place it over there. So one is done, then the second one. Okay. Go to the fourth one. Right click, remove my item from scope and delete. So this fourth one is also done. This is the correct and exact method. Okay. You should not follow any other method. This method you have to follow. If you're clicking on this one, create slash after items, some people are clicking, but those all the things will, you know, the assemblies will appear. But again, you have to rearrange those all the things. Okay, it is a time taking. So starting on what's only let it be time taking, but you have to follow you. Why can't you follow the right method? So this is the method you follow every time. So 1, 2, 3, 4 done. The fifth one. Now again, drag and place the main assembly. Okay, right click, insert procedure, provided part. So two times, you have to click. So more than 400 components are there. Okay, so for this, so it may take some time, but anyway, we will do it. No stress. So what I'll do is that I'll drag and place part over here. Just one. Not gone. Okay, inside that. Okay, so it is gone, right? Now it's gone. So for this also, what I'll do, right click, okay. So this fourth is also done. Sorry, fifth is done, I think. Fifth or fourth. Now we'll go for the sixth. Can you people tell me what I have to do now? I hope many of you, I think, understood. Now we'll go for the sixth one. Sixth one, what I'll do, I'll drag the main component and place it over here first. Okay, then right click. How many components are there? Just one component is there, right? Insert procedure, provided part. Then just drag and place it, that item over here. Okay, one part is there means, so there is not required to do again because already it is appearing, right? So one part is there means you just leave it. If more than one part is there, then you have to keep. Any doubt is there, guys? Please let me know if any doubt is there. Now we'll go for the other one. This is done now, seven. So for seven, see, here's some four parts are there. So what I have to do is, the first I'll drag the part and place it over here. Okay, this came. Now what I have to do, I have to click on four times because four parts are there. So let me hide this provided parts. This is a very interesting topic, and from the next time, next class, next onwards, we will be learning so many things. Okay, so very interesting things are there. So go to the insert procedure. Four times you have to click on the provided parts. So one time I have clicked. Again, I'll go to the insert procedure, provided part. So two times more. Now, I'll expand this. Drag and place it over here. All the four things. Okay, now this one, right click, remove item product scope and delete. It's done. So seventh one is also done. Four things left. After that, we'll be discussing about the process planning. Please guys, please let me know if you are not getting something, please let me know. Because this is very important thing. You are getting, right? That's good. So the same, only four items are left. Okay. So I'll go to the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4. These four items are there. I'll go to the next one. So see, for this, how many items are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 items are there. Okay. So you have to, keep your patience. Okay. So first, let me drag the part. Okay. Yeah. And after that, what I'll do? I'll expand this and 9 times I have to click. According to whatever the whatever the things we have done in MGO, according to this you have to do the process planning. Okay, so this is totally a time taking process. I am telling you repeatedly. Okay, but anyway, we have to achieve this one. Okay. So 9 times you have to click because 9 parts are there. You all of you, like those people who are having Dalmia, you please, you can get the part and the slides and everything you can take from me and you can practice the things. Okay, those people who are having the Dalmia. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 9 times, 5 times more. Just one, and after that today only will, if possible, we'll do the process planning. Yeah, some people raise their hand. Any questions you want to ask? So just 1 minute, guys. So it's nothing, just to we are whatever the assemblies are there, according to that we are just following the method, nothing else. So according to that we are doing the planning. Okay, in this is the method, this is the basic method. Okay, and we'll follow and we'll manufacture all the parts. That's it. That is the only our target, nothing else. So how many times we have done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3 times more, right? Right click, set this here. Propagated parts, 7 times done. It's not allowed. Right click. provided part. The time is done. Now one time more. Or else you can right click from here also. If you are not getting the tile, so you can right click from here, insert feature, and directly you can click on the property part. Now you drag all the 9 parts and place it over here. So every time you try to use a drag and drop method, okay, there are 3 methods you can place the parts. One is by drag and drop, assignment manager, assignment assistance. Okay. So, but I would like to tell you that you should prefer the drag and drop method. It is much more effective. Okay. So you should prefer this method only. So drag one. Okay. Then two. Okay. One, two, three. Three is done. So four is also done. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to remove the item structure store and delete. That's it. 7th is also done. Not 2 times left. 4. Please guys, please let me know if you are having questions, anything you want to ask. If you're not getting something, I want you all people to learn effectively. You know, there should be no doubt, nothing should be there. End of the day, like you should learn it, like learn the perfect manufacturing process. So 7 times is done. So I'll go to the 8 times now. So 8 times, how many items are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts are there. So I'll drag the part, place it over here. Now what I will do, again, you have to click on the insert pieces and provided parts. So it is going to be end. So there is no problem. Just within 5 to 10 minutes, we are going to complete this all the things. Okay. Provided part. 4 times. Two. 3 times is done. Now last one. Okay, now what I'll do? I'll go to that one. This one, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times we've done. Now what I'll do? I'll expand that one and drag and drop the parts from here. 1, then 2, then 3, and then 4th, just 1. Okay, just okay, 2 times things are there, I guess. Harsh not coming. Just one minute. Problems are there, I guess. Okay. For example, this time, as you can see, I tried the drag and drop button, but due to compression, okay, but you have to drag, you have to bring them over here, right? So for that, what you have to do, you go to the assembly, sorry, you are in assembly design. That is the reason it is for time. And in the drag and drop, please see here. Okay, you are in assembly. So by mistakely, I came to assembly design. So that is the reason when I'm doing the drag, it is not coming. Okay. So make sure you should be in the item definition application. So what I have to do, I have to go to the PPR content. I go to the top. I click on the PPR content. Okay. So please make sure you should be in the PPR context only. So double PPR. Yeah. So now I came back to manufacturing item definition. Now what I'll do, I'll do the drag and drop. Now it will come. Okay, see, this time it came. So previously I was in an assembly design, so it was not coming. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll remove the item product scope and delete this one. This is not required for us. Okay, so this is done. 9 times is done. Not 2 times more. So you hide this one. So I'll go to the 10 and after that we'll go for the process planning. Okay. So this is the 9th one. The 10th one, sorry. 10th one. The 10th one, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts are there, I feel. I guess. So what I'll do is I'll drag the main part. Main assembly, then right click, insert procedure, then 6 times you click on the provided part. Never and ever, I'm telling you, those people who know Delphi, they might have clicked over the case class update in the item structure. Never and ever, you please do not do this. Okay, if you are doing this, it will come, you know, the assemblies will come. Okay. So it is a kind of big headache. Okay, so never and ever click on this clear slash update. Okay, you create your own plan. So 6 times, let it be time taking, there is no issues, but create your own plan. Go to the insert procedure, again go to the provided. So 3 times we have done, I guess. Fourth time, okay, done. The time, then last one. Now, find this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, drag and drop. Simple. Second. R. Just one. The 6th one, final one, and here is the final, and here no, like finally how can you remove, so just remove the item prep score, right click and delete. This is not required for us. Okay, now the final one. And here is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 items also available here for this. Okay, again 6 times. So I guess some people might have feel bored, but there is no problem. It will, the interesting topic is also coming, because it is also at the same time almost is going to complete. So there is no problem. Just wait for 1 or 2 minutes more. We'll completing this MID, then we'll move to the next process planning. How many times is done? We have done 4 times, I guess. Yeah. Time. This is the last one. And the last 6th one. Okay. Now what I'll do? Again the same. Just drag and place the main assembly first. Make sure you should drag it properly. Okay. Now drag and drop. Product assignment successfully. Still is not. Maybe I think let me check what is the part. Go to the 3D view and select the part from here. Whether it is okay. What is the part you should know? Okay, these are all the things. Okay. So we'll be trying. It would not be assigned. So this, so the last one we'll see. Okay, these are the fasteners, right? Okay, that's why it is not coming. Just one. Instead, this is the fastener is there. Yeah. Fastener, yeah, here one option is the fastener. Okay, so click on the top option. Click OK. Okay, and after that you drag the fasteners from there. Because these are the fasteners. Just one. The first one is there. Okay, so these are the small fasteners are there. So we'll think about this one later. So before that, let me check whether all the parts are assigned or not. So in order to check that one, you have to go to the BSNSL tool. Okay. So that BSNSL tool is available in the tools. Go to the tools. Okay. Then BSNSL. Okay. Then select the MBOM. So as you can see, we have converted the EBOM to MBOM here. Okay. Here is the MBOM. So select the MBOM and choose the information. to check item completion status. Item completion status. So as you can see, all the things are in green color. Okay. Item is not completed because there are some fasteners are there, right? So those fasteners need to be kept here. Okay, so that is the reason it is showing that item is not completed. But most of the assembly parts have been assigned, and the you know all the parts, assemblies parts, all the things are assigned. Okay, so we have to think about the fastener. Okay, then after we can go ahead with the we will go to the next step, that is process planning. So how many of you understood this one? Yeah, there is no issues. Like, we will be providing the PPT after the end of the session. Okay, so please create any WhatsApp group or something. I will share the PPT over there, both the PPTs, so that you can go through the PPT and you can clarify your doubt. But what I'm asking is, is there any doubt related to the practical session? Please repeat once. Which one I have to repeat? Can you please clarify? Which part I have to explain? Okay, so I will be repeating once again, but the thing is that I'll just explain the things. Okay, I'm not going to do anything. Okay, just I'll explain the things. So first thing is that when we open the first thing what we've done is that we have imported the physical product of this turbofan assembly. Okay, so after that what we've done, we went to the manufactured item definition application. Okay, so after importing that one, after importing, we went to the manufacturing item definition, and there what we found, there was a manufacturing assembly was there, and this physical product was there. So we have created a scope between that. So as you can see, what I've done, I have right click on the manufacturing assembly, I have created a scope, one option was there at the time, create a scope, save the product item scope. So I clicked over there, and after that I selected the physical product. Okay, and after that we have successfully converted the EBOM to MBOM. Okay, so that is the first step. Okay, after the first step, the second step was like, I went to the physical product, how many assemblies are there, I checked over there. So I found that 11 assemblies was there. Okay, so under one assembly, there are different parts also was there. Okay, so what I've created is that I have created 11 manufacturing assembly tiles over here. In front of you all of you only I have done. Okay, last process. Okay, again, I'm repeating all the processes. Okay. So what I've done, I've created 11 manufacturing assemblies. So in one manufacturing assembly, whatever the part is there, suppose in one assembly, four items are there, four parts are there. So what I've done, I have used the drag and drop method and kept inside the, I've created some provided part tiles. Okay, and I have done the drag and drop methods, used the drag and drop method and kept the parts in the provided part tiles. That's it, nothing else. Then what I've done, in order to check the status, whether all the parts are assigned, whatever the parts are there in the physical product, whether it is all the things are assigned or not, to check. So to check the status, what I've done, I gone to the BI sensor tool. Okay, and then what I've done, I went to the item completion status. One tool is there, so I clicked on that one. Okay, after that, as you can see, it is showing that item is completed. Whatever the item it is there, it is assigned over here, but these are the fasteners we haven't assigned. Okay, you have to check like what is the problem like we are facing for the fastener. So we'll do that one. right click, insert preciser, fastener is there, right? Fastener. So I'll click over there. And I'll start importing these things over there. Yeah, MBOM means manufacturing bill of material. Okay. EBOM means engineering bill of material. Okay. Why it is showing orange? Yeah, because the thing is there are all the things we have assigned, but the last one, 11 one, there are some fasteners are there. Okay. So we haven't assigned those fasteners over here. That is the reason it is showing orange color. Okay. When we'll assign those fasteners, then it will also appear in the green color. Okay. So that is the last item we haven't assigned. Okay. But the concept is clear or not, I want to know. Just 1 minute. I'm trying to put these fasteners over there, but I don't know why it's not going. We try to put this one. Product assign successfully, it is showing, but anyway, there is no problem. These fasteners will think about this later. Why it is not coming? Okay. So after that, the next method, like what I told you. So just 1 minute. So this man, this manufacturing item definition is completed for today's session. So I will tell you about the next one. Just 1 minute. So I will be showing you the pictures, whatever the things we have done today. So as you can see here, what happened, like first process is creating and managing the MBOM assembly. Okay. So we have, as you can see, initially we have imported and created the scope and converted it into MBOM. Okay. First method. Then second method, what happened, we have done, define the MBOM assembly and sub assemblies. So what have done, we have created the, the manufacturing assembly. Manufacturing assembly tiles, 11 tiles were created. Okay, after that, what happened? We have started assigning the parts. Okay, so 11 parts we have assigned. Okay, so under that, as you can see, create and manage groups. Or under that, as you can see here also, he has created different kind of, provided part tiles, and he has assigned all the parts, related to that assembly. So he has completed. Then the final, the fourth one is like he has done the review, assignment status. Okay, whether all the things have assigned or not. So we have checked that one also. At the same time, we have created and managed the groups also. This is also done, okay, in front of you all people. And these are the some pictures. Okay, here it is not coming, blue color, green color, because the fasteners we haven't assigned. Okay, so this is all about the MID. The first application, like we have discussed, so I'll show you the other methods also, other processes, like what are the next processes we are going to discuss. Okay. So today we have completed this one, manufacturing item reference, but I don't think so, like much time for this also, 3 to 4 hours required for the process planning, because if we start today means, it may be difficult. It may be difficult for you people to understand the, you know, the basic concept of the process planning. So it's better like we'll start tomorrow, the process planning, because it is also time taking process. Okay. Then the time motion study is also there, and equipment allocation assembly. After that, slowly we'll move to the other things. Okay. So how many of you understood the manufacturing item definition, or whatever the question is there? Okay. So you please ask me. We'll continue the session till, okay, there is no problem. You please ask me, or else if prepared, we will move to the process planning. I'll show you some of the things. That's it. Please ask me if any doubt is there, any questions are there. Please let me know. Well, if required, we'll start the process planning also, no problem. Okay. So this is the manufacturer item definition is completed. Okay. So what I'll do is that the next one, at least 10 or 15% will start today. Okay. So next one, what I'll do is that I'll go to the B plus R. Okay. So 10 to 15% will try to cover the process planning. Okay. Then rest of the things we'll be discussing tomorrow. So I'll go to the process planning. Okay. I'll open the process planning application, because here almost all the things done. Okay. So as you can see, here is the PPR context. Here is my physical product. Here is my MO. Okay. And here is my process planning work plan. Okay. So what I have to do is that initially when I have entered to process planning, I have to create a product scope between, MBOM to work plan. Okay. So for that, what I'll do, I'll right click on the work plan and I'll go to the create scope. Just one. I'll go to the right click on the MBOM. Okay. I'll click on the manage scopes. And I'll select the just one. Again, I am moving. No problem. So as you can see, here is the PPR context. Here is the physical product. Here is the MBOM, and here is the work plan. Okay, but you know the physical product is not appearing over here, right? So in order to get that one, what you have to do? You have to create a scope between work plan to MBOM. Okay. So what I'll do? I'll right click on the work plan. I'll go to the manage scopes. Okay. And I'll click on the create scope, okay, and I'll select the MBOM. Okay, so after that, as you can see, when I created a scope, after that, as you can see, that is my physical product is appearing over here. All of you can see, right? My physical product is appearing over here. So what we will do is that whatever the things we have covered in the MID, okay, we have done a plan, right? So those all the things, whatever the components are there, we'll do the process planning for that. Okay. So are you people getting me, or any doubt is there? So 11 times we have created the manufacturing assembly, right? And we have assigned the different parts, to the assemblies, right? In the MID we have done. So the same thing, you know, for that MID, we'll do the process planning. Okay. Hello. Any doubt is there, guys? Please let me know, or shall I need to repeat the process planning? Please ask me doubt. If you are having any doubt, please ask me. So whatever the things we have done in the MID, we are going to make a plan for those particular items in the process plan. Okay. In order to manufacture that one, we have to do a plan. Okay. So the planning can be done in the process planning only. Okay. So please ask me if any questions, no doubts, right? Okay. Good. So am I need to repeat this one? Am I need to repeat? Okay. So somebody has written, repeat. Okay. No problem. So as you can see, again, I'm repeating. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm closing this one. Okay. Okay. So the MID is over. Now the next work is process planning. For process planning, I'm doing it I'm repeating it once again. Please check once again. So what I'll do, I'll go to the B plus R and I'll go to the process planning application. Okay. Okay. So process planning application has opened. Okay. Now I'm removing the So as you can see, here is the PPR context. Here is the EBOM. I mean, here is the physical product. Here is the MBOM, and here is the work plan. Okay. So what I have done, I have right click on the work plan. I have created a manage scopes. Okay, and I have selected the MBOM. That's it. Nothing else. Okay, so already it has been created. That's it. I created that much only. Nothing is there. Okay, it's very simple. Okay, so now what I have to do, I have to create a process planning for the 11 assemblies. 11 assemblies, whatever the parts are there inside the assemblies, those are all the things what I will do. Okay, so what I will do is that I'll create some stations. This is the work plan, right? So what I'll do, I'll create some stations. So I'll right click on the work plan. I'll go to the insert. Okay. And I'll go to the work plan again. I'll select the work plan again. So 3 to 4 stations I'll create. Okay. So again, I'll go to the work plan, insert, and go to the work plan again. And say at the same time, I'll go to the insert work plan. So first thing what I'll do, in order to manufacture those 11 assemblies, what I'll think is that within the 4 stations, I'm thinking that, within 4 stations, these all the things can be manufactured. These all the 11 assemblies can be manufactured. I'm thinking, this is my plan. So what I'll do, I'll right click on the work plan. Okay, and I'll create 4 stations. Okay, this is one station number 1, station number 2, station number 3, station number 4. 4 stations I have created. Okay, so under these stations, okay, I have to follow some operations, because those operations only will provide me the parts, right? So what I'll do, so you can rename, okay, if you want, but I don't want to rename now. Okay, just you assume that these are the stations I have created. So what I'll do, I'll go to the insert. I'll go to some operation. I have to perform some operations, right? In order to get the components, in order to manufacture the components. So in the station number 1, what I'll do, I'll perform some 1 to 2 operations. So similarly, in the other stations also has been, what I'll do, I'll do the same. Are you guys getting me? So you can create general operation, feeder operation. There are different operations are there. If you're not getting something, please ask me now. So similarly, here to what I'll do, I'll create some more operations over here. So transfer operation also can be done here. These are just operations. Okay. So in the second station number 2, I have created 4 operations. First station I've created 2. In the third station also I'll create 2 to 3 operations. So just 1 minute. What I'll go to the fourth session and I'll send some operating software there also. Just one. Is there any doubt, guys? Any doubt is there on it? Yes, I need to repeat. Please let me know. No doubt. I'm trying to tell you in a simple how you will be able to understand the things. Okay. Okay. So in the last, what I'll do, I'll also, I'll open some operations over here. Or else you can write it from here also. If you are not getting something from there, write it from here. So you can write material cutting, remove material operation. So regarding this header, general operation, remove material, these all things I'll elaborate tomorrow. Okay. The basic definition. Okay. Then transfer or loading. What is the purpose of this operation, that operation? All the things we'll be discussing tomorrow. Okay. That's not a big issue. Then as you can see, so the here, as you can see, here is the main station. Okay, and so this is the main, which is like Orca, and these are the four stations I have created. Okay, like for your understanding, I'm just keeping names also. If required, you can edit the names. So station number one, so S1 I'll give. So one is S1. So when you combine these all the stations work, then you will get the final product. Okay. So I'll give the S2. This is the S3. The final one is S4. Then, as you can see, so here is the my main product. My target is to manufacture this one. So in order to manufacture this one, what I do, I have to make a process plan. So for that plan only, what I've done, I have created four different stations. Okay. And in each stations, okay, what I've done, I need to execute some operations, okay, in order to manufacture some parts. Suppose station number one, I will manufacture some of the components. Station number two, I will manufacture some of the components. So similarly, station three and station four also. I will be manufacturing some other components. Okay, when I'll combine these all the things, what I'll do, I'll get my final output. So, and after, so voice is lagging. Okay, no problem. So I'll collapse. I'll expand once. Okay, so this is all about the station 1, station 2, station 3, station 4. And in these stations, I have some operations. That's it. Then now what I will do, I have to create a product flow. Like, see, after this operation, I will move to the next operation. So these all the operations complete in the station 1, then I'll move to the second station. Okay. Then similarly here, all the operations I have to do, then I'll move to the next. So what I'll do for that, I have to make a product flow. And I go to the create product flow. I select the operations, first operation, second operation. Okay, when these operations completed, I have to move to the next station, right? So what I'll do, I'll give a product flow between stations. Station number 1, station number 2. Okay, then I move to the second station. Here what I'll do, I'll give product flow between all the operations. So create product flow here to this, then this to this again. Just one double click for multiple. Then again, I am telling this product flow can be given in the multiple ways. Okay, it's not like, you know, this station to this station, not like that. Or this operation. After this operation, I can move to the last. Okay, as per your requirement. Okay, as per the demand. Okay, if you want to execute the first operation and you want to complete the operation in the station number 1, and after that you want to move to the station 4. Okay, so that can be done. Okay, anything can be done. Okay, but as I told you, as per your requirement and as per your demand, as per the demand. Okay. So I want to follow the simple method. Similarly, this station, I have to give a create product flow between this station to second to third. Now what I'll do, I'll give for this also, I'll give. So here also 3 to 4 operations are there. So similarly, we'll give for these all the 4 operations a product. So how many people understood? Can you please tell me? Like if you are not getting, please let me know. Please tell me what are the things we have discussed today. Please let me know. If any doubt is there or anything else you want to know for any clarification, anything, please ask me the questions. Please respond, guys, so that I'll move to the next. If there is no questions of them, I'll move to the next. Okay, I guess no doubt is there. Yeah. Why you created only four stations? Yeah. The thing is that, as I told you, what I feel is that there are there are some 11 assemblies are there, and in those 11 assemblies there are I think 40 to 50 components are there. Okay, 40 to 50 parts are there. So what I feel is that I have segregated those 50 parts into four stations. What I feel is that, like, for the, in order to manufacture these 50 parts, I feel like four stations are enough. Okay, so what I've done, I have created four stations for because of that reason. So for example, if you feel like, no, I need 10 stations in order to manufacture these other components, so you can create your own plan according to your idea and whatever the because I have to create the resources according to this process planning only. If I'll give, number of stations, more number of stations means I have to get more of a number of resources, and it may be time taking. So what I feel like, in order to reduce the time and to complete the manufacturing in a better way. So what I've done, I have created four stations only. So if you want, like, you can create multiple stations and multiple operations also created. Can be created. As I told you, this is all about the requirement. Okay. So any more questions, like, if you want, like, you can ask me. Which place the aircraft manufacturing company is given? Which place? Which place means, I didn't get your question. Can you please? So company name, I told you, are you asking about company name? So company name, I mentioned in the PPT itself. Which state? So which state means, like, you are asking about the manufacturing company where it is available aircraft? No, please ask the questions related to the things, whatever the things we have discussed today. So this is all about the things. Any doubt is there still? I'm asking, any doubt is there? Hello, move it. Can you send this model? Yeah, I can send the model. There is no issues. Like, please provide, this model PPT and whatever the this recorded session, each and everything will be provided to you all people. Okay, so there is no problem for that. Okay, so it will be provided. There is no issues. But in order to practice this, like, you should have the access. So like, once you get the access, you can easily practice this all the way. Okay, so what I'll do, okay, so now the work is to assign the parts to different stations and operations. So as you can see, I'll go to the MBOM now. So as you can see, at that time, I have created the manufacturing process planning. See, here I created manufacturing one, manufacturing two, 10 manufacturing assemblies we have created, right? So those things belong for me, to assign the parts. Easily I can assign the parts in the process planning. See, we have created 11 manufacturing assemblies, right? So those things will be helpful now for me. Now those things will be So Salud, go ahead. Okay, so what I'll do, I don't think so, like everything can be assigned to today, but definitely we'll have to do some of the things so that at least you will understand the concept. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll go to the manufacturing assembly first. Okay, and here, as you can see, three parts are there. Okay, so before that, what I'll do is that I'll go to the BI Essential. So BI Essential later will go, there is no issue. So I go to the custom manufacturing assembly. I'll assign all the three parts, you know, whatever the three parts are there inside that. So we'll assign all the three parts first process. Just one minute. So station number one, operation number one, we'll assign to all the three parts. We'll assign to the operation number one. Okay. So what I'll do, you can click shift, you know, if you want to, you know, assign multiple items, sorry, control, not shift, you have to click on control if you want to assign multiple parts. So just one minute. Because just one. Just one minute. I'll start assigning the parts to different you know, to all the stations and to the operations as well. As just one minute. Go to the BS instance. Okay. So after I'll go to this, okay. So as you can see, first one. So I'll select the first thing. What you have to do is that you have to select the BSNL, okay. And after selecting the BSNL tool, you have to go to the item assignment status, okay. Option from there, okay. So as you can see, after selecting the item assignment status, okay. So as you can see, all the things are showing, so it is in orange color. So assignable items, so it is going to be assignable, so we are going to assign. So what I'll do, I'll select the first one and I'll directly click on the operation, okay. So as you can see, in the first operation, what I've done, I've assigned the first assembly, okay. So the same thing will be moved to the next one also, because here whatever the things will manufacture, it will move to the next. Here something will manufacture and it will add over here. So what I'll do, I'll go to the second one, I'll drag it and drop in the second assembly, okay. So you can see first assembly, this much has been covered, and then second assembly, this one, this shaft has been manufactured and it is added to this blade. Okay. So then we'll move to the next third one. So the same thing, the second one will be moved to the third, fourth, fifth, and other things also as well. So what I'll do, I'll expand the third one. I'll assign some of the parts of it. So the parts cannot be assigned. Okay, directly you have to assign the product, the assembly only. Okay, so third also we have assigned. Now I'll move to the fourth. And I'll select this one. Okay, so as you can see, here I have assigned another one. So fifth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now 6 more left. Now I'll assign this one to this, the 10. I've assigned this one also. No. So just one. The questions are coming. So just one more, guys. I'll remove some operations. I think so many operations I've created, so I can remove. This one. Okay. And the last two, I'll assign to the fourth one. So as you can see, so there is some differences, but it's not showing. Okay. So here is the, so we have assigned all the components to this, all the four stations. Okay, in the station number one, what I've done is that I created two operations. Okay. So first operation, what happened, this blade and other item is there, that is manufactured, the first operation. In the second operation, what happened, the blade has manufactured and added to it in the second operation. then the first session work is completed. Okay, then after that we'll move to the next session. In the session number 2, just see. So session number 2, what happened? Like here you can see here some of the parts component added, and here this one added, okay, the other component, okay. And at the same time, here is the cover. The cover is added in the second session end, okay. Then at the third also, there are some internal components are there in the third and fourth session. Those components have been added, in the final one, we got the output. Okay, so like this, we have assigned all the components to different stations and the operations of the these all the stations. We have assigned all the components to the stations and the operations. Okay, so is there any doubt? So today we have covered manufacturing item definition and process planning. Is there any doubt, guys? Yes. Are you there?
Yeah, Tapan. Yeah, tell me.
So, for today, like we have completed the, we completed the session for today. Okay.
Okay, sure. Okay. Guys, if you have any doubts or anything, we still have the time. You can just ask in the chat box. It will be cleared here.
Please ask the doubts, like guys, if you're having any doubts. So that those all the clarification can be given over here.
Guys, everyone, no need to give your details here. It will be recorded previously only. So if you have any doubts, only then use the chat box.
And yes, like what I'm telling is that can you please add me in WhatsApp group? Anything is there, means please add me. So that what I can do, what I will do is that.
Tapana, there is no WhatsApp group here. There will be it will be mailed through a drive. Venkat sir will be taking all the PPTs and everything. He'll be having that and he will be sharing the through
the
drive.
Okay. Okay. So yeah, no problem. Like, okay, then that's okay. Thank you. So if any doubt is there still, I'm asking. If any doubt is there related to today's session, please let me know. Like today we have discussed about the the basic of Dalmia, then different approaches, like what are the approaches like we have to follow in order to manufacture the this turbofan assembly engine. Okay, and after that what have done, we have covered two basic process, okay, of the process planning, that is MID, manufactured item definition, and the second application is process planning. Okay, and tomorrow we will be discussing about the time machine study, okay, and the equipment allocation tomorrow, and then in the final day we will be doing the revision of these all the things, and we'll be completing the assembly evolution in the final day. So today, if you are having any doubt, please let me know. Again, repeatedly I'm asking. So So today's whatever the things are there in the schedule, so we have completed all the things. Okay.
Tapan, one had asked like any other software for Telmia.
Yeah. Yes, there is no other particular just one. So there is no software is there. Okay. But what can be what they can do is that they can because Telmia V5 this file may not be supported to Telmia V5 this software is there, but this file may not be supported to that particular software. So what we will do is that we will provide the PPT and recorded session and all the things this time. When they will come back to the college, they can practice this particular model. They can create the plant layout of the this air gap engine at that time. So this time this for the practice session there nothing can be done, because if some people are having the 3D experience platform, please let me know so that I'll provide the digital product to them and they can practice. So that is the thing. Yeah, regarding the material also, there is no issues. So PPTs can be said, that's not an issue. Okay. Could you save the 3D expense license? So now regarding license and all the things, you please, we don't have much information related to that. Okay. B5 R20 is different from this here. So B5 R20 cannot be, we can't run because that is KTI software. This is Telmia. It's totally different. If any other questions related to today's topic, please let me know, guys. Which simulation software is now training in now? So yes, he's asking about the simulation.
What we did it's basically Telmia part. It's a manufacturing.
So SS is expert in the related to
the simulation part. Like that's so what I was saying. The total thing it is divided into three parts, like this CAT aids for designing and Telmia for manufacturing, simulation and simulates a different part. So simulation it will be comes in the simulator also and the abacus is there. So the simulation you can do over there. Right now most of you who are working in the new abacus is the better version for you guys to work on that. The coming sessions will be there on the simulations. You'll be knowing much more about that.
Yes. No, the Telmia cannot be used in the KTI where you create the initial turbo part. No, initial turbo part. The model is already available with us. Okay. From the cloud server, it is already available, so there is no need to create any part. Okay. So he's asking about the software link to you. Yes. Regarding the abacus.
Yeah, in the coming sessions, I'll be telling you from where you can download that one.
So still I'm repeating, like if any doubt is there, please let me know so that we clarify all the doubts of you all people. You can write in the chat box as well, as no problem. Send the WhatsApp link, but it's links, sir. Can you please? Yeah, please send me the WhatsApp link. so that you know I'll join in that group. So whatever the information is required, me and ESS will provide you all the necessary information to you all people. Okay.
The recorded video and the PPT, everything, it will be shared through mail and WhatsApp. It won't be there. Like only through mail we will be communicating with that.
Okay, okay, no problem. Yeah, so only through mail you will get your all information. Okay. By listing, we can't get much doubts and knowledge. By practicing, we can get many doubts. So kindly provide. Yeah, that's not an issue. Like for providing for the software and these all the things, like we don't have much idea on that. So, So once you back to college, you can.
Guys, like in the college, your trainer might be having the link for the, it will be sent from the APSDC. You ask with the trainer, they will be provide one link to 3D experience. If you get the student license from that link, then Delmia will be also there. You can try it from there also. Just ask with your trainer in your college.
So he's asking about the, can you repeat what is Delmia and Simulinks? Yeah, Delmia is all about the, you know, the manufacturing part. Okay. So, and the simulation is all about, you know, to get the impact, you know, to know the principal stress and strain and, you know, then heat analysis, you know, the thermal heat analysis, then the structural analysis, there are different kind of analysis are there. Okay. And, you know, these all, so simulation is all about the analysis to, you know, to know the impact of, you know, on a product. Suppose, for example, you're applying a particular force or something on a product. Okay, so how it is going to be react? Okay, so to get the impact only. So, but anyway, ESS can give me the, you know, the more clarification related to the simulation. So, ESS.
Like what Tapan said, it's related to same only. Like in the Delmia, it will be only manufacturing. After creating the manufacture part, like you will just import the simulation. After that, you will just give the all parameters, like different kind of parameters like pressure, stress, and the load. All these things will be implementing on the product. And after that, we'll just simulate and we'll see what kind of results we'll get. That is what simulation is, means. The simulation and Delmia both are different. The simulation you'll be getting to more different kind of analysis like impact and stress analysis, dynamic, this kind of analysis will be doing
the simulation. Dynamics, implicit dynamics, these all the things. Like that, for example, one vehicle is moving in 100 kilometer per hour and it is, you know, striking to a wall or somewhere. Like, so how the build quality of the vehicle it is going to react. So those all the things can be covered in the XP dynamics. Okay. So similarly, there are many kind of, you know, analysis can be covered by using simulation. So ESS will be, you know, coming in upcoming days. He will be telling you about those all the things. Okay, so there is no issues.
Regarding Delmia, if you have any doubts, you can ask the pundit.
Yeah. So tomorrow, like when you will come, so we'll be covering this time motion study. So time motion study is nothing but like, as I told you, like for a particular operation, like by default it is 20 seconds, right? And at the same time, sequence of operation. After this operation, what is the operation I should do? Okay, these all the things are coming under time and study. Okay, so these all the things we are going to cover at the same time. So the process planning also, we will be repeating once again when you will come back. Okay, so what I'll do is that I'll what I'll do is I'll put in the favorite. I'll have two favorites. Okay, at the same time, I'll export. So you should know like how to export this one. So here one share kind of icon is there, right? You click over there and go to the export.
Tapan, you are showing me anything on screen? It's not so been shared.
Yeah, just one. Okay, sorry. I forgot to share the screen. Just one. Sorry. Yeah. So am I my screen is visible? Yeah. So what I was showing is that. Tomorrow when you will come back, like we will be, you know, we will be repeating once again, you know, this process planning. And at the same time, like we will be, you know, after that, like we'll discuss about the timers and study. Like it is all about the related to, you know, to provide the, you know, what is the, you know, what is the time, how much time, you know, this particular operation should run. And at the same time, sequence of operation, the Gantt chart also, I saw you these, all the things like we will be discussing in the time. Study. Okay. Later on, if time is there, like we will be discussing about the equipment allocation also. So equipment allocation means what? Like there are different kind of resources that are there, like conveyor belt, storage, you know, like toolkit. Okay. So these all the things are there, and so by using these all the resources, we'll create a station, and we'll be getting the tracks and everything. Okay. If tomorrow time is there. So, and we will be simulating these all things. So, like once these were all, you know, all the tracks and the resources provided, we'll be creating a track. We will be simulating these all the things, you know, after the completion of equipment allocation. So, those all the things are coming on assembly evaluation. Okay. So by slowly, like within the upcoming 2 days, we'll be covering these all the rest of three, you know, applications. Okay. So I'm sure like you all people will be getting some good output, you know, so there is no problem. And at the same time, see, I have already kept into 8 favorites. Okay. So tomorrow when you will come, there will be no problem for us to, you know, import this one. And at the same time, exporting this one. So I'm telling you how can you export this 3D model, you know, the Telmio file, you know, to our desktop. So I'll click on the share option. I'll go to the export. So it is okay. Unsaved. Okay. So it is unsaved. It is showing. So there is no issues. When you will come back, tomorrow again, we'll run the sessions. Once again, we'll run. Okay. Skin files. So skin files can be saved, but yesterday, okay, he's asking about you. Yes.
It will be shared. In the middle of the last of the workshop, the whole thing, every recorded and the files will be shared with you. Don't worry about that. Everything will be shared.
So any question related to Delmia, please let us know, or Delmia, or like from the last 2 days also, like whatever the SS has delivered, you can ask related to questions related to that. If some people are not getting, there is no problem. We can clarify your doubts. Yeah, recording session will be provided after completion. There is no problem. You will be receiving all the things through your mail. Okay.
I guess, Tapan, no more doubts, I guess. We'll wind up the session then.
So, Salu, we wind up the session. So, please, Venkat sir is here.
Venkat sir. Venkat sir, are you there?
Venkat sir?
In 1 minute, I'll just contact him and I will.
Okay, no, no problem. So, yes, can you leave?
Yeah, Tapan, we can leave. Thank you, Yashas.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, Tapan.
Sir.
Yeah, we completed, huh?
Yes, I completed, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Tapan. Then I will wind up the session, okay?
Yes, sir. Thank you,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Thank you,
both of you. Thank you.
Thank you.